Chernobyl helicopters. After the Reactor 4 explosion, these machines and their pilots were the only ones capable of accomplishing the impossible: sealing the reactor, mapping the fallout, and decontaminating the area. The risks were enormous, and some missions claimed lives. Among these daring operations, there was one few know about: Operation Needle. An 18-meter steel probe was dropped into the core of Reactor 4, designed to uncover its dangerous secrets. It was a complex and heroic effort, but years later it was discovered that it had ultimately failed in its purpose. This is its story. On May 5th, 1986, in the office of the head of the Instrument Design Bureau in Tula, a phone rang. On the line was Yevgeny Velikhov, Vice President of the Soviet Academy of Sciences. Velikhov explained the situation. Helicopters had created a thick crust of sand, lead and boron over Reactor 4, meant to suppress the burning graphite. But the reactor's behavior itself remained a mystery. The upper layer of this crust needed to be monitored for temperature and radiation levels to get the data critical for planning the next steps. Velikhov requested a solution, and yet he had no idea that by chance he would later become directly involved in its deployment. The first solution was developed by Vladimir Shklover, who, along with his colleagues, designed two devices. One would enter the layer under its own weight, while another used a kinetic impactor to reach depths of 2 meters or 6.5 feet. In just a few days, both systems were ready and Shklover headed to the disaster zone. Deployment was planned in the days following May 12, 1986, but that morning horrifying news arrived. A glowing was observed inside the reactor. This suggested unknown activity that made deploying the probes not only impossible, but largely irrelevant. Instead, they needed to go deeper. Various alternative solutions were brainstormed, but it soon became clear that the only viable option was to drop a heavy, narrow impactor probe from a helicopter. So Shklover returned to his drawing board. And his new proposal was bold: an 18-meter-long steel pipe packed with sensor to measure gamma radiation, neutron flux, and temperatures. The device also included a video camera to assist the helicopter pilots, all connected by a 200-meter cable. Weighing 600 kilograms and only 100 millimeters or 4 inch in diameter, this probe could break through the reactor's crust upon impact. This instrument was named the Needle. Two needles were manufactured, one for training and one for deployment. On June 9, they were transported to the city of Chernihiv, 50 miles away from the power plant. There, engineers installed a cable system and mounted lights to help pilots locate the reactor's opening. And just think for a moment how complex this task truly was. To precisely hit the target from 200 meters, in conditions of unpredictable turbulence caused by rising air currents above the reactor, surrounded by extreme radiation. So for this, they needed a superior pilot, and they found him. This is Mykola Melnyk, a first-class pilot who was assigned to the zone on May 20. No attempts to place the test needle inside the reactor were made due to the lack of accurate radiation maps. Instead, on June 13, a test of placing it in a 2-meter square area was conducted successfully. Eventually, on June 19, 1986, on 9 a.m., Operation Needle began. Melnyk took off in a helicopter with probe suspended below. The first part of the operation involved transporting the needle to the reactor and ensuring all systems were operational. Then it had to be dropped, and here things went unplanned. The first two attempts failed. The needle stuck reinforced debris and bounced off, damaging the camera and lights. So instead of relying on the camera image, the crew had to visually observe from 200 meters above. But on the third fly, Melnyk's extraordinary piloting skills paid off. The needle pierced the crust, embedding two-thirds of its length into the ruins. The heroic pilot and his crew spent 36 minutes over the reactor. That felt endless. At the same time as the needle was placed, a Soviet television crew was walking with high scientists inside the plant, documenting ongoing work. After the needle was inserted, the helicopter had to release the cable, which could later be connected to equipment located in a safe room. But suddenly the lock failed and the cable fell in an unplanned spot near this window where the levels on the ground were astronomical. It happened just minutes before the scientific group arrived. The person breaking the glass and catching the cable with DP5 dosimeter probe was Vyacheslav Pismenny, doctor of physics. And the man in the dark helmet pulling the cable was Evgeny Velikhov, the vice president of the USSR Academy of Sciences, who had initially requested the needle's creation. And while some of the needle's detectors malfunctioned, by 4 p.m. of the same day it began transmitting vital information. It showed temperatures ranging from 57 to 370 degrees Celsius. This data was valuable but soon raised questions as it didn't match other measurements and estimations. When the buoy program introduced a new set of detectors in July, the differences became even more apparent. The mystery was solved only in 1989, 3 years later, when radiation levels dropped enough for closer visual inspection. It was discovered that the needle had missed the reactor shaft, and instead it pierced the nearby pool for spent nuclear fuel, which was empty during the disaster. Anyway, although only partially successful, Operation Needle made an important contribution for understanding the condition in the reactor's central hall. And its data, though flawed, was a step forward. For his work, Vladimir Shklover and his team received commendations from the Soviet government. Their ideas eventually laid the foundation for more advanced diagnostic systems. In 2017, shortly before his passing, Shklover documented the story of the needle in his book. Mykola Melnyk continued his work in the zone, and by September 1986 he completed 46 flights, spending a total of 52 hours in radioactive skies. For his bravery, he was awarded the title of Hero of the Soviet Union, though at a great cost. His cumulative radiation dose reached 160 rangens. Melnyk later became a flight instructor in Spain, but his health deteriorated and he passed away in 2010. If you made it this far, thank you for watching. In our next episode, we'll explore other, no less significant efforts undertaken in the aftermath of the Chernobyl disaster. And in meanwhile, check our Patreon page for bonus reading related to this episode and other unique insights about Chernobyl. The link is in the description below. This episode is a part of a series, so check out our other documentaries. We have many, many interesting things to watch. And see you next time in the next episode of Chernobyl Uncharted.